Dear friends, welcome to our class. Today we study about large intestine. Large intestine is the last part of the gastrointestinal tract. It is 5 feet long and 3 inches in diameter. 5 feet long and 3 inches in diameter. It is the most responsible for absorption of water from the indigestible residues of food. The main regions of large intestines are the cecum, the colon, and the rectum. This region is called the ascending colon. This region is the ascending colon. It including cecum and appendix. Cecum and appendix. Then this region is the transverse colon. And this region is the descending colon. Then rectum. Rectum leads to anus. Rectum is the concluding part of the large intestine that terminates in the anus. These are the different parts of large intestine. The digestive waste left after the absorption of nutrients moves towards the large intestine. A major portion of the salts and water left after the absorption in the small intestine are absorbed in the large intestine. Then certain bacteria residing in the large intestine, they produce vitamin K. Absorption of these substances also take place in the large intestine. Then the digestive waste stored in the rectum are eliminated out through the anus, which is the functions of large intestine. Absorption of the salts and the water left after the absorption of the small intestine are absorbed in the large intestine. Then certain bacteria residing in the large intestine produce substances like vitamin K. The digestive waste stored in the rectum are eliminated out through the anus. Digestion takes about 4 to 5 hours to complete. If you take any heavy food items like meat, chicken, etc., this time is varying. If you take simple food items, we need only small time. That means in the beginning of this chapter, Adityan raised one doubt. What is then? Plants which prepare and use food by themselves do not have a digestive system. Then, why do we who receive food from plants have a digestive system? You can find its answer. From this lesson, we study what is the digestion. We can understand what is the different steps of digestion. You can find its answer. Yes, we know digestion is the process of conversion of complex nutrients into simple and easily absorbable form. We take different type of food items. That food contain different type of nutrients. These are the complex nutrients. These nutrients converted into its simplest form or its easily absorbable form. That process is called digestion. But in plants, they prepare their own food by photosynthesis. Its food is the glucose. Plants prepare glucose, which itself is a simple nutrient. So it need not undergo further digestion. Plants prepare glucose, which itself is a simple nutrient. So it need not undergo further digestion. Okay, you can understand what is the reason?
A graph prepared to show the relationship between food and health is given here.
You can read this. Improve the food quality and keep disease away. And there we can see some points to think. Fiber, essential component of food. Avoid fast food and junk food. Health matters more than taste. After reading this graph, this boy has one doubt. If indigestible fibers are included in our diet, will it cause us indigestion? First, we want to discuss about roughage. What is the roughage? Roughage or the fibers refers to the carbon in plants that your body cannot digest. It does not provide any nutrient to our body, but also plays an essential role in your intestine. It helps to keep food moving through your digestive tract. It is recommended to improve digestion. Which is the sources of fibers? Cereals, vegetables, fruits and nuts are the important sources of fibers. Through fiber content in the cereals and vegetables do not undergo digestion. They help in the absorption process, ease defecation and thus protect the health of the digestive system. What is the importance of roughage for a healthy digestive system? It helps to keep food moving through digestive tract, improve digestion, helps in the absorption process, ease defecation, prevent constipation, remove waste and toxins from the body, helps to clean the colon, helps to manage weight, reduce risk of heart disease. These all are the importance of roughage for a healthy digestive system. Next, health issues created by junk food and fast food. What is the junk food and fast food? Junk food is an unhealthy food that is high in calories with negligible nutrient value and are often high in salt, sugar and fat. Junk food is an unhealthy food that is high in calories with negligible nutrient value and are often high in salt, sugar and fat. Fast food is the food that can be prepared and served quickly. Fast food is the food that can be prepared and served quickly. Health issues created by junk food and fast food. We are discussing about junk food and fast food. Now we can understand what is the junk food and fast food. These food items causes any health problems? Yes. It causes digestive system. It makes digestive issues, mainly slows down the digestion. It leads to obesity, depression, increases cholesterol, leads to hypertension,
stroke, different heart disease. Sometimes it leads to cancer. Then it leads to memory and learning problems and early death. These are the main causes of junk food and fast food.
These monosodium glutamate mainly included added in the Chinese food, canned vegetable soups and processed meats. These artificial food colors and tasters, these are not good to our health. If its excess use causes many serious problems to our body. Mainly, it makes the digestive disorders like diarrhea, vomiting, etc. Then, it affects to nervous system, respiratory system. It makes respiratory disorders like asthma. Then, affects to skin. Sometimes it leads to skin problems like itching, rashes, and swellings, etc. Selecting food items by giving importance to taste can be harmful to health. Health through food should be our motto. Health through food should be our motto because health of the individual is the foundation stone for the progress of society. Harmful chemical substances added to food to enhance its taste and color. Selecting food items by giving importance to taste can be harmful to health. Which is the harmful chemical substances? These are artificial food colors and artificial food tastes. Brilliant blue, indigo caramel, sunset yellow. These are some examples of artificial food colors. Saccharin and monosaccharide glutamate. These are used commonly in commonly it is used as food tasters. This monosodium glutamate is mainly used as a flavor enhancer. It's a common. Second lesson, food through digestive tract. In this lesson, first we are discussing about different type of nutrients and its function. In the we understand carbohydrate, protein, fat, minerals, vitamins and water. These are the different type of nutrients. Then we study the structure of digestive system. It includes mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. Then we are discussing about the structure of tooth. The tooth divided into mainly three parts, crown, neck and root. Enamel, it is the white in color, that hardest part and dead tissue. Dentine, pulp, cementum, these are the various parts of a tooth. We study different type of teeth, incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Then what is the role of teeth in this digestion? Then we study which is the methods to protect the teeth. We are discussing about the passage of food to esophagus through the pharynx. In there we study two main structures, Veola and epiglottis and its role. Veola and epiglottis and its role. In there we understand, don't speak while eating. From the esophagus, the food reaches to the stomach. In the stomach, gastric juice contain different components, pepsin, gastric lipase, hydrochloric acid and mucus. We understand its role. From the stomach, food moves to the small intestine through the duodenum. In that time,
two type of organs we study, liver and pancreas. Liver produce bile and pancreas produce pancreatic juice. Then we study the functions of pancreatic juice. Pancreatic amylase, trypsin, pancreatic lipase. These are the main components in the pancreatic juice. Then we understand the structure of small intestine. Small intestine is the point of completion of digestion, and it is the starting point of absorption. This is the structure of villus. Villus helps to increase in the surface area during absorption. From the small intestine, simple nutrients absorbed to the blood or lymph through these villus. After the completion of digestion, complex food materials are split into its simple, easily absorbable form. Carbohydrate converted into glucose, galactose and fructose. Protein converted into amino acid. Fat converted into fatty acid and glycerol. Other nutrients are actually simple nutrients. They can directly absorbed into the blood from the small intestine. We are discussing about different process of absorption. Simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis and active transport. After that, we are discussing about the importance of roughage in our food. Then what is the health issues created by the junk food and fast food. Then how chemical substance causes harmful to our body. That points we study from this lesson. I think this lesson helps to give good informations in our life. Okay.